A lot of people ask me, Albert, how do you start a business from ground up? What do you do? How do you do it? And from experience, I learned that you need experience in that industry. Or not, hire somebody with experience, team up with somebody that has experience. So for me, I was in the business in 2005, I started in the mortgage industry. So I'm new to the business and I have to figure it out. They just throw me in there. They give me a farm package with phone numbers to just call people cold and ask them, do you guys want a mortgage? Do you want to refinance? Do you want to buy a house? Let me qualify you. All from scratch, I have to figure it out. And it's horrible. No training, no nothing in this company. And that's how I started. At the time, 2005, 2006, 2007, there's a lot of fraud going on, a lot of stated income, negative option arms, loans. What that means is if you're making, let's say $15 an hour working at McDonald's, all you gotta do is, hey boss, can you just confirm that I'm a manager and I'm making $500,000 here at McDonald's because I'm a manager? Yes, okay, they call, verify, over the phone, done. You qualify for $1 million home because you're making $500,000. What you do is, let's say your payment is $15,000, give or take. So your payment's $15,000, but the bank is allowing you to pay half of that. So you pay $7,500, and then the rest, the other $7,500, get added to your loan principal. So it's a negative arm. The difference, whatever you're not paying, is getting added to the principal balance. So your mortgage balance is going up every month. But the lenders don't care because they're thinking, wait, values are going up, up, up. There's no, we're not gonna lose. Like, just add balance, add to the balance and we're gonna be fine. It's gonna keep, the market's gonna keep going up, appreciating forever. It's never gonna end. Big mistake. And a lot of fraud going on, because obviously that's fraud. You're not making $500,000. You're not making $250,000 a year. You're making 15, 17 bucks an hour, but you're stating that you make more. That's fraud. So what happens? 2008, I go out of business. Experience. Best experience you could have is when you go out of business, but you stay in the business and then you start again. You keep fighting, you keep trying, you don't give up, you don't quit. Very important. So then 2010, 2013, 2010 through 2013, I joined this other company. Okay? No culture, no vision. They don't have a vision, they don't think big, and there's no culture. It's just like dead. Nothing wrong with the company. They're doing good. You know, people are doing okay, but there is no culture, no vision. We're going here, we're going there. None of that. None of that. It's like a dead company with no environment. Like the environment sucks. So I'm done. I'm done with this company. I'm going to start my own company. I want to start my own company with the culture that I want, with my vision, with think big, $1 billion company. And I'm thinking big and I'm like, how am I going to do it? I've never started a company, but I have experience. I have $3,000 in my bank account and my credit's barely recovering from 2008 when I lost it all and I became homeless and I had to sleep in my Ford Explorer for 2 months. And I start my company and what do I do? What do I do? So I had experience from the past, from the first broker to the second broker to I'm gonna create my own company. And what I do is I get a mentor. Very important. If you wanna start a company, besides experience, get a mentor. Somebody that has mastered what you want to do. Somebody that's living the life that you want to do. You gotta watch the source of your advice. So if you're gonna get a mentor, don't hire a mentor, don't get coaching from a broke person. Somebody that's driving a cheap car, somebody that lives in a cheap house. And I'm just being straight up and blunt with you guys. Like, why would you take advice from somebody that's living with their parents? Somebody that doesn't have a house? Somebody that doesn't drive the car of your dreams? Doesn't live the life of your dreams? Watch the source of your advice because there's a lot of people out there giving advice, but why would you listen to them? If you partner up with a dumbo, you're gonna become a dumbo. You're gonna create a dumbo company, okay? Watch the source of your advice. That's the main thing I want you to get from this. So what do? I get a mentor. I have a little bit of money. I put all my money on the line and I hire this mentor. And this mentor starts teaching me. You know what? You need systems. You need to, sales are one thing, but you need systems. Marketing comes before sales. So let's just say you market and then you get a lot of sales. You get a lot of leads. You close them. So it's marketing, then you master sales. But then what happens when you're marketing and you're getting a lot of sales and you're growing, you're exploding, you're gonna get growing pains. You're gonna go through a lot of growing pains. And if you don't have systems in place, you're gonna go out of business. You know, there's two ways that companies go out of business. They grow too slow or they grow too fast. And the biggest mistake I made was I didn't pay attention to systems and to operations. Once I got this mentor, he started telling me, you gotta put attention to operations, systems. You gotta create systems because people do not like to think. If you create systems so good, people just follow the systems and they know where to go from A to Z. You gotta create your systems so good that the company runs without you. Hopefully this is helpful. If you guys want me to go deeper into anything that I said, please comment below. We're gonna do this every Friday, so stay tuned. And for next Friday, I want to know, what do you want me to cover? Thank you.